See, we are learning about the river valley civilizations, is it? So based on that, we have learned four important civilizations: Indus Valley Civilization, Mesopotamian Civilization, Egyptian Civilization, and Chinese Civilization. All these four civilizations originated in the river valleys. Okay. In the previous class, we have learned about the Mesopotamian Civilization. Today we are going to see about the Egyptian civilization. In Egyptian civilization, we are going to see some of the things today. See, these are the things we are going to see in this class. Introduction, we are going to see sources, location and origin, river Nile, about the river Nile and about the river valley, and different kingdoms we are going to see today. When we see this Egyptian civilization is known as the land of mysteries. Okay? Egypt is known as the land of mysteries. Why we say Egypt is the land of mysteries? Because we know that we can find pyramids, tombs, sphinx and obelisks. Okay, these are the different things we can see in Egypt. And one of the ancient wonders of the world also found in Egypt, that is the pyramid at Giza. And when we see Egypt also originated in the river valley of Nile. Okay, in which river this civilization originated? In the river valley of Nile. And when we see when this civilization originated, this civilization originated between the years 3000 to 1000 BCE. So around 2000 years this civilization flourished. How many years this civilization flourished? 2000 years this civilization flourished. When we see this civilization, we are learning about Egyptian civilization, is it? Where is Egypt located? Egypt is located in the northeastern part of Africa. Where this civilization is, Egypt is located. It is located in the eastern, northeastern part of Africa. We know that in Africa there are around 54 countries are there. Egypt is one of the countries. And we see this river valley, this Nile River Valley is the fertile land. It is the narrow strip of land. It spreaded around the length of this valley is 1200 kilometers. Okay, what is the length of this valley, river valley? 1200 kilometers. So when we see this location we are learning about. It is located in the northeastern part of Africa. And when it originated between started around 3000 BC and it ended up in 1000 BC. So 2000 years this civilization flourished. And when we see sources, what are the sources? How do we know about this civilization? Okay, we know this civilization through the archaeological excavations. Okay, there are three important sources are there. The first one is archaeological excavations, the second one is inscriptions, and the third one is official documents. So these informations gives us about the Egyptian civilization, how it flourished, how it developed, and how long it flourished in the river valley. And the next thing we see is the river Nile. Okay, when we see a river Nile, in all the river, the reason for the civilization to be flourished was this rivers used to overflow, or sometimes the rivers used to change its course of direction. That's why these civilizations flourished, developed in the river valleys. Okay, here when we see this river, Nile River, we know this river valley, the length of Nile River valley is 1200 kilometers. And this river valley, this Nile River also, it used to overflow. Okay, so when it overflow, it deposits black fertile soil in the banks of the river. So the land, the soil of this land is so fertile, okay, which helps to yield a rich harvest in this region. And when we see this fertile soil, this helps to produce more production. So the surplus yield this soil gave from this river valley. And we see this Nile River, it also helps for irrigation. It helps for the irrigation, which supported the agricultural activities in Egypt. And the next thing, when we see this Nile River, it also used as a transportation. So we learned this highway, this length of this river valley is 1200 kilometers. And when we see this Nile River, it also used as the highway in Egypt. It helps for the transportation. Because of this Nile River, the foreign trade also improved and developed in Egypt. The people, the merchants, they had the trade contact with the foreign countries, which helped them to develop their economical activities, to develop their wealth. And when we see this river, it used to overflow, I said, is it? So what the architects of Egypt had done, they have constructed dams, dikes and reservoirs. Okay, what are the things they have constructed? They have constructed dams, canals, dikes and reservoirs. And because of these things, the irrigation activities that promoted the agricultural products, and it increased the agricultural products more. And when we see this Egypt, in Egypt there were three important kingdoms. One is Old Kingdom, the Middle Kingdom and the New Kingdom. How many kingdoms were there in Egypt? Egypt was divided into three kingdoms: the Ancient Kingdom or the Old Kingdom, Middle Kingdom and the New Kingdom. Okay, and what's the period of these kingdoms? The period of Old Kingdom is 3000 BCE, okay, to 2000 BCE. And the Middle Kingdom is from 2000 BCE to 1700 BCE. And the New Kingdom is from 1600 to 1100 BCE. BCE. So this is the period of the three kingdoms. And what about, there is a gap between middle kingdom and the new kingdom, 100 years of gap. Okay, what happened between this 100 years? This 100 years, there will be a tribe called Hyksos. What's the tribe? There is a tribe called Hyksos. They ruled for 100 years. And after that 100 years, what happened? There was a king called Menas. Okay, what's the name of the king? King Menas. He unified this kingdom. Okay, he unified the kingdom. There were three important kingdoms: ancient kingdom, middle kingdom, and new kingdom. Okay, so this is the period of ancient kingdom. What's the period of ancient kingdom? From 3000 to 2000 BCE. And the period of middle kingdom is from 2000 to 1700 BCE. And the new kingdom is from 1600 BCE to 1000 BCE. There's a gap between middle kingdom and the new kingdom, 100 years of gap. During this period, there was a tribe called Hyksos. They ruled in the period of between middle kingdom and the new kingdom. And this Egypt also divided into two parts. One is lower kingdom and the other one is upper kingdom. Okay, upper kingdom and the lower kingdom. And the lower kingdom located near the river Nile. And the upper kingdom located in the north of the lower kingdom. And when we see this upper kingdom and lower kingdom, there's a two division in Egypt. It was divided into two parts. So what happened later, King Menas, he unified these kingdoms, and there was kings, they changed into pharaohs. The ruler of Egypt is called Pharaoh. So king or the pharaoh, Narmer was the first pharaoh in Egypt. What's the name of the first pharaoh? Pharaoh Narmer. So this is about Egyptian civilization. So this is the beginning part today we have seen. Okay, what all things we have seen? We have seen introduction. In introductory part, what you have learned? It was called as the land of mysteries. Why do we call Egypt as the land of mysteries? Because pyramids, temples, tombs, and obelisks were found in this region. One of the ancient wonders of the world also found in Egypt. That's why we called Egypt as the land of mysteries. And source, what are three sources? What are the source? Archaeological excavations, inscription and official documents. And location, it is located in the northeastern part of Africa. When it originated, 3000 BCE, it lasted till 1000 BCE. So it flourished for 2000 years. And when we see this next one, we have learned about river valleys. So river valley is extended till 1200 kilometers, and Nile River is used for transportation and irrigation. And people settled in this region along the river valley because the soil is fertile. People cultivated the land, okay, because soil is fertile. They have cultivated lot of crops. The surplus food production was done in this region. And canal, dikes, dams and reservoirs were used for large irrigation activities in Egypt. And Egypt was, there were three kingdoms in Egypt. One is ancient kingdom or old kingdom, middle kingdom and new kingdom. There was a tribe called Hyks, ruled for 100 years. Okay, and there were two divisions in Egypt. One is Lower Egypt and Upper Egypt. There was a king called Menes. He unified these two kingdoms. And later, King Norman became a first pharaoh. Okay, this is about today's class. So read your books till kingdoms in your book. Thank you, children.